Hey, thanks for watching this quick video. In this video, Caleb Salibi shows a couple things that he found on an install, and there's some really key points here, but something I wanted to point out quickly, and I'm gonna show you some images here. He talks about taking the drain line and dropping it down to the platform top, but he does it in front of the filter, and you can kind of push it up. I prefer to actually take it around the corner. A lot of people will say this is unnecessary. We started doing this just out of experience because we had a lot of cases where the water in the float wouldn't rise high enough because of the pan depth to actually trip. It's one of these things that you can mount it in the front and a lot of times it won't be an issue, but in terms of access and the ability to get the top off, to access the float, to access the filter, and in terms of being able to make sure that the float switch is in the right position, those are all things I look for. So again, accessing the float, accessing the filter, and having the float in a proper orientation so that way the float isn't gonna stick, that's what we're looking for. He also shows some other good tips. So here you go, Caleb Salibi talking about float switches and wiring position.
So we're here at a new install. Everything looks pretty good, other than a few things that may be nitpicky. You guys can let me know in the comments, but what we like to do here with these SS2s, for one, how am I ever going to get this? They tightened it really tight. I have a fear of cracking primary port there, or the secondary port. Can't get this float out because the suction line's in the way. Two, we've got our electrical coming in through here, but if you look closely, there is no insulation on the inside there, so it's rubbing up against the discharge line in heat mode. This is a heat pump. We have a potential for wire rub out, which would cause the system to shut down. We would have a low voltage short to ground at that point. Also, what we like to do is we like to 90 down or at a 45 degree angle, and then we'll add another 45 and then our SS2. Essentially what that's doing is it's creating a trap for the secondary drain line so that it's going to fill up faster and we're not going to end up having water sucked in through because it's still under a negative pressure. So we're gonna fix this. We're gonna also correct this. We're probably gonna go run down the side. We could even run through here, just insulate this part right here because it does get a little hot, not nearly as hot as the discharge line though. Another thing, some people like to mount the thermostat right on the air handler. This is an application where it's not a huge deal. What we have to understand is that the electrical compartment in the air handler is not airtight. It's not completely separate from the blower housing in that area, in the coil area. So we are gonna get a little bit of infiltration through the hole that is punched through here where our wire is coming in. So whatever temperature is being displayed on this display, on the thermostat, it's not going to be completely representative of the room air. It's going to be mixed with whatever infiltration we're getting from inside the cabinet. When at all possible, we can mount it on the wall, we can mount it here. We definitely don't want to mount it on the system itself because issue as far as accuracy of the display on the thermostat. So we just finished the repairs that we made on this system. This was kind of a jungle, so we just kind of neatened it up a little bit. It's not a huge deal. It's a super nitpicky thing, but made me happy a little bit. We had the float switches, those wires were coming in through the cabinet. They were all up and touching the evaporator coil, which would get extremely hot in the winter time. And then it was coming out through here, which would be the discharge line in the winter in heat pump mode. We had potential rub out here. We removed that and we just went through the rubber grommet at the top where the thermostat wire was coming in. We tracked along with it and we moved auxiliary pan. So we just relocated the pan switch. For the SS2, this is what we did. This is exactly what I was suggesting earlier. We 45 down, we added another 45, and this is essentially a trap because we're still on a negative pressure. This float switch, this well is going to fill up a lot faster now because it's not having to overcome the negative pressure. This is a trap. And what we didn't do, we didn't glue this particular joint so that if we ever had to, especially with this filter, we can take this off, move this up, and then change the filter easily. Okay, real quick, I want to add a little bit of clarification on the video. In the video, you can see that it was very much extended. The reason for that is what we were doing the best that we could with what we had. The technician that was there before us had glued the reservoir to this SS2 to the male adapter. So, and that was into the secondary switch. The secondary port, drain port. And what we didn't want to do was take out a perfectly good brand new SS2 and replace it with something. So what we had done was we did a threaded coupling. We stubbed out of the 45 here and then we added a threaded coupling and then we attached our SS2. Ideally, we wouldn't want to do that because the longer the PVC pipe that we run, the longer it's going to take to fill up that reservoir in the secondary float switch. So this is the ideal setup. This is how we really want to get this thing designed. So this could also be a threaded 90 going out of the secondary port. And this is, we would still not glue this port right here, and just in case we needed to detach this, slide it up, and then remove a filter. But this is how we would typically do it. We would want to stub directly out of this thing here. And then that, what that's doing is, you can, there is also another, an easy way to test this to prove that this is actually going to fill up quicker. All you'd have to do is take a bottled water that's capped, poke a hole in the top of it so that you can control the flow of water that's coming out, and then fill up the primary pan just enough so that it's just on the edge of that secondary port, and then pour the water through it, and you can time it, see how fast that this reservoir is going to fill up compared to the just the stub out of the secondary. If you got a slant coil, just get up there and pour the water in.
Again, thanks to Caleb, and thanks to everybody who contributes videos to our video channel. If you ever have something that you want to send my way, feel free to do so. Brian, B-R-Y-A-N, at HVACRschool.com. Catch you on the next video.